holidays are a perfect time to try Thinx. Thinx can't make that family time any easier, but they can make travel a lot easier. They make amazing presents, and the final sale of the year is 20% off of everything, December 26th to December 31st. So that's today to New Year's Eve. You get an extra $10 off with my link, shethinks.com.
As you know, this show is here to motivate and inspire you to live the life you deserve. Because let's face it, we do not have a dress rehearsal. This is the only one we have. So you might as well live your best life now, right? So I have had many guests over the years. We've had Elvira Guzman of LVGPR, Shanti Das, the hip-hop professional of Press Reset Entertainment and Silence the Shame, Cupid of The Cupid Shuffle, Lisa Nichols, Paul Carrick Brunson, a whole host of wonderful people to share their stories. And today is no different. We're going to have an amazing guest. We are going to have Josie Harris Thacker, who is, you'll figure it out. When you see this, you'll know.
Party time.
Yeah, what? Come on.
Welcome to the show, Josie.
Hey. Thanks for having me, sweetheart.
So I am so excited. So first I have to tell the story. I was a dancer. I danced tap, jazz, and ballet competitively for a lot of years. I think I quit when I was like 16 or 17. And so I used to love In Living Color because it was funny, but I loved watching the Fly Girls because I was a dancer too. And then Josie did Renee, and Renee was my song because that's my name.
Oh, that's right. How cute is that?
When I listened to the song, of course, Renee was in law school. Well, I had always dreamt I'm going to go to med school. So I said, Mom, look, Renee's in law school, and, you know, I'm going to go to med school. I go, this is my song. This is me.
The real Renee.
Right. Then when I created my very first website, my senior year at Michigan State, the song when you entered my website was Renee by the Lost Boys.
Because wow.
And there were several songs that had my name in it. Of course, you know, LL Cool J, Around the Way Girl. My name was in that song. And then there's a Kay Solo song. But this was my song. Like, everyone knew I love the Lost Boys, period. But then they said Renee.
It's a classic, and I love, it's still one of the hottest and one of my favorite hip-hop classics to date.
Right, exactly. Yes. And so yes. Josie played Renee in the video, and of course, I knew she was because I watched In Living Color so intently. Every video I think she was in, I don't know how, but somehow I'd find her and say, oh, there she is! And actually, I even had the hairdo with the
dookie braids gave me away all the time.
I had that too. So I just have always been a fan. And so when I heard actually like 2 years ago that you were in Chicago, and I was like, oh my God, when am I going to run into this woman? I have to run into her. And then my wonderful friend, Sandria Washington, was, you know, posted. She's hosting the summer dance series ending and co-host. And I go, oh my God. I sent her a message. I go, you just don't understand. She goes, well, come. And so, of course, I went. And so I got to meet Josie, and it was just a wonderful fan moment. Full circle.
You were so awesome, too. It was a pleasure meeting you, sweetheart. Yeah.
So I just want you to share your story because, like I said, I know I didn't ever want to be a professional dancer, but I, too, am a triple threat, though. I dance, I sing, and I act, and I know you act as well. And so I just want to hear your story of how you came to you. So first, you're from Harlem, New York, and you were not even classically trained.
I was not.
What was the first one, and how did it come?
Oh, God, I can't even tell you what my first job was. I'm really, okay. And we're having a little issue with the lighting here in my.
Oh, I see. It goes and comes.
It's coming in and out. So I'm so sorry about that. I don't know what's going on with the lighting in here, but But I don't even remember what my first job was. People ask me that all the time. I can remember the moment when I was approached at a club in New York and somebody asked me to dance for their music or to audition for their music video. And what a lot of people don't know is that I had a business background. I was going to Pace University for business management. And I had been already working in Wall Street in the mergers and acquisitions department right after high school because I was in a co-op program. So I was about my money. So the first thing I asked was like, are you going to pay me? You know, and right. And it was all business from then on. And because I really wasn't a professional dancer at the time. There really wasn't such a thing. Right. Yeah. There weren't music videos were it was a new look and a new idea, a new concept. And that was when they started bringing us on as the dancers.
So who was that first music video?
I don't remember who the first music video is, girl. I really don't. It was, you know, some small group.
Okay.
But then obviously I went on to work with, you know, some of the bigger groups and stuff. But I cannot even tell you. I've done so many videos. I can't. Right. I forget some of them. Like some of them will pop up because somebody will, you know, share one on social media. And I'm like, oh, my God. That's me. I don't even remember doing that video. I did so many over, you know, just over time. But one of my first big ones, I would have to say, would have been for, I don't even know. I don't even know, girl. Don't get me to lie. I'd be guessing.
But guys, you feel like you were doing enough of that where you could quit the job? Because, I mean, you had a nice job, obviously. When did you feel like, okay, we can kind of transition over and this is going to be something I can do and make a living out of?
I think early on, I knew that I was onto something. You know, I was really negotiating my own deals, and I knew I was kind of making more money than some of the dancers because I was some of the other dancers because I was able to negotiate my own deals. I'm sorry, I'm just gonna keep playing with the lighting here. It's so
it's
bad.
Okay.
Can you see me?
I can.
I can't see me. I knew earlier on that I was onto something and there was something here because, you know, it was just steadily growing, you know, the business was steadily growing. And I was a professional dancer. I ended up being a professional dancer. It's just sort of something that happened. It was kind of a no-brainer. Mm-hmm. I just started being requested. You know, I had very much a look and everybody was requesting me, literally, like the girl with the braids, the dancer with the braids. I was always requested. It just became my career. It was my thing to do. I was on tour. I was dancing for all kind of late night talk shows, Arsenio Hall, David Letterman, I was just being requested to dance with all these musicians as they were blowing up. You know, we were blowing up with them,
right?
As their dancers, you know, because it was this sort of new concept of music videos with dancers, you know, in it to hype them up even more, you know. So it was just such a good time. It was just such a good time.
And then you toured with them too, right?
And then I toured. I've toured all over the world. You know, I was just a little kid from Harlem. You know, my mom was a single mom raising five of us. My dad was a Rolling Stone. He would come in and out of my life. You know, I was totally a daddy's girl, though. God bless his soul and rest his soul. My career took off. There was no, you know, I was attending Pace University at the time, but, you know, I was like, peace, y'all. You know, I'm out. I mean, it was such an adventurous time, you know, and I, outside of me leaving Harlem, My first time leaving Harlem was when I won a writing contest for it was a writing contest for each borough in New York City, and I entered for representing Manhattan, and it was about like how we could make, you know, the subway system better. And so my first trip out of Harlem was from Harlem to Germany.
Oh, wow.
That was when I was, I don't know, in my, I was probably about 12, 13. And then the next time that I traveled was, you know, just maybe once or twice I had to go to LA. And then it was just touring. And I toured the world, you know, and I saw the world as a dancer. So, yeah, I've had an amazing life. Amazing. It continues to be amazing.
Yes. Right, definitely.
You know?
Yeah.
I'm definitely in my second half of it, and it's just amazing, really. God has been really so good to me.
That is wonderful. So how did you break into the acting?
So the acting was it just sort of came naturally. I was, you know, I had gotten In Living Color, right? They approached me. Oh, I hate this lighting. I'm so sorry. The producer in me is having a hard time with the fact that the lighting is not good. But it was a no-brainer, the acting bug. It happened when I got cast as one of the Fly Girls. And I had a chance to be around all those amazing actors and comedians. And sometimes while the rest of the girls would just leave after rehearsal, I always stayed around to watch the actors do their thing. Cause I was just so fascinated by it and them. And so I naturally got the acting bug, you know, and I really watched their process. You know, I didn't know what I was doing at the time cause I didn't know I was going to end up being an actor. Jennifer Lopez, who you know was my girlfriend at the time, we were really close, and she had started auditioning. She had gotten herself an agent and stuff, and had started auditioning. Oh, Renee, I'm so sorry. I'm doing you so wrong with this lighting. I'm sorry.
But it's a beautiful day in Chicago today. We cannot complain.
No, we cannot complain at all. But I want to help you out so I can see me a little better. So Jennifer started to sort of audition first, and she had gotten herself an agent. I remember when she booked, like, I forget what the show was. She had booked the show. And I remember I had hooked her in to dance with Janet and I and the crew. And that's how she ended up doing That's the Way Love Goes with us and stuff, the video. But at that same time, we were preparing for Janet's tour, to go on tour. And that's when she got that show, that television show, her first television show. And I remember her calling me and saying, oh my God, Josie, what do I do? You know, I'm supposed to be going on this tour with Janet, but I just got this television show. And I was like, girl, you better go do that television show. You tripping, you know, whatever. And her career took off. And now she don't know me. No, I'm just kidding. sort of kidding, but not kidding. She's cool. That's my girl. That's how I caught the acting bug, though. It was a no-brainer. I started to pursue my acting career. I really, really fell in love with it. I started to work with some of the top acting coaches in LA. And they all took me under their wing, and they were like, you're so good, Josie, you know, and you know, really, really helped me and shaped me into the actor that I am today. And then I met this one acting coach who, you know, started to talk a different talk to me in terms of the process. His name is Rick Edelstein. He's one of my best friends. He's 87 or 88 years old now.
Oh, wow.
And one of my best friends. I consider him one of my best friends. And he was an acting coach, but he was coming from a director's point of view. And so when he started teaching and coaching me, it just changed my whole perspective. I had been told that I was kind of like always coming from a director's point of view, like I was a closet director. And, you know, today I've come into that. But at the time I was like, director, oh God, you know, that just seemed like such a big word and sort of above me and bigger than me. So I never saw myself a director. I never saw myself as, as like being able to be a writer even, because I'm also writing my first book, which I'm really, really excited about. And so I started training with him, and he just the words he used and his process was just something I had never sort of heard and experienced. And it really spoke to me. And I ended up really growing tremendously as an actor. Well, I don't know, about maybe a year or so later, he decided he was going to retire. And I was just like, oh my God, absolutely not. You cannot, how are you going to retire? You know, we've got to help actors to learn this process. And I genuinely naturally fell into becoming an acting coach. It was really, really selfless. And I believe that's why I'm walking in my purpose. It was a selfless act, which was to really help my actors and help other actors like me learn this process that to me was just changed my career. I started booking more. I started owning the room more. It was more of a way of being, you know, and really owning who I was, you know, and who I am. And so with his blessing, I was like, can I teach this? Can I, you know, whatever. And with his blessing, he gave me all of his tools and said, you absolutely can. And if there's anybody that could, it's you. And I've had his blessings ever since. And that's how I got into teaching acting and becoming an acting coach. Never in a million years did I see myself becoming an acting coach or teaching people and having, you know, and being, this type of businesswoman, this type of entrepreneur. But it's really, really wonderful that I get to do this. I really, really love coaching. I love teaching. I'm good at it. You know, you can love a lot of things, but are you good at it?
Right.
Are you supposed to be doing that? You know, but I am. And you know, my actors booking and, you know, getting leads in movies when they've never done anything before, doing guest star roles and recurring roles speaks to, you know, it's what I'm supposed to be doing, right? So yeah, it's been amazing. It's amazing. It's all very amazing.
So you're, I know that you worked with the Clark Sisters movie.
Yes. How do you know that? Oh, that's right. Christine.
Yes.
Which is how we hooked up, right?
Yeah. Well, right. Meets Andrea and Christine. Yeah. So yes, and I met Shalaya because of Christine. So I
got you. You got to meet Shalaya. She's amazing. She's my angel, as I call it, my butterfly.
And so now, you know, the trailer came out this week. For
I didn't even know that.
It's all over now. I'll send it to you, but you'll run into it. It's been posted everywhere. Today's Wednesday. It must have been posted like Monday.
You know why? I'm not on social media. That's why I don't know that.
Okay.
Yeah, I took a little
break.
Just a little break. Yeah, I needed it.
So the trailer came out this week, and so it looks amazing.
Okay,
everyone needs to watch the Clark Sisters, because my last guest, Christine Swanson, directed it. Shalaya, one of her wonderful students, acted as one of the Clark Sisters in the movie.
And Kiara Sheard.
I coached, from Detroit.
Absolutely. Yeah. I coached her through the entire process from beginning to end. Yeah.
So both of them said, spring. It doesn't give us a date, but it says lifetime spring. So
yes, yes. I'm super, super excited. I'm super excited to watch them shine in this movie. It's a piece that should, a story that should be told.
I totally agree.
And I can't wait to see Christine's beautiful work in it. She's an amazing director. Yeah, it's because of her that I was blessed to work with those incredible artists, because they're both incredible. Yeah, so yeah, I was fortunate enough to coach those two through.
Okay, yeah. Wonderful. And I saw that you were in Black Korea, and Erica Watson was in that, as well as, of course, that was another movie that Christine
Erica
did.
That's my girl. Yeah. Yes, that's my girl. Yeah,
she did. And I saw it. That was a very good movie.
Oh, yes. Well, Christine, you know, directed that as well. She's an amazing director, and we've only just seen the beginning of her greatness. Honestly, she's amazing. It's been wonderful. It's been wonderful. Right now, like I mentioned, I'm working on writing a book. My first book is really speaking to my actors and to my dancers and even to people out there who struggle with interviewing. But it is a passion book. It's a passion piece because I wanted to be able to help my actors actualize their dream. And most of the time, what keeps us from actualizing those dreams is that we're not able to really be present in our auditions or in the interviews because, you know, our nerves get the best of us.
Yeah.
And then, you know, we're not able to do and shine the way that we're supposed to because it's just so much pressure on us. So my book is going to be a book that I hope will have a long life, shelf life.
Okay.
Because there's really nothing out there, you know, that really addresses that and really helps us as actors and artists deal with the nerves that can be crippling and that can keep us from really actualizing those dreams. So it's a book I'm really, really excited about, you know, sharing with all of you. So you should be seeing that in 2020. And I talk about my experience working with, you know, all of my actors. You know, I've got Khalil Everidge too, who's also from Chicago.
Okay.
Who starred in Beats.
Oh, okay.
Netflix. He's a client of mine. He had not done anything before, you know, worked with me, and we worked hard to, you know, get him that role. And he went on to also recur on I can't think of the show. It's an Asian show. Oh, well, not an Asian show. It's like a karate show. A Karate Kid.
Okay.
Forget what it's called right now. But Cobra Kai. That's what it's called.
Okay.
Cobra Kai. My mind didn't fail me this time. You know, I've got my production company, B Fly Create. You know, where I produce projects, direct projects, you know, for anybody interested in bringing me on to their projects as well. But my whole production company is B Fly Create is really based on what I believe. So B is something I really live by, which is being in the moment, being present. Like there's nothing more important to me than being with you right here, right now, doing this, having this moment with you. But B also speaks to, you know, what I work with with my actors, which is, you know, learning to be in the moment, as we have to be as actors. And then Fly is, I was taking advantage of the Fly Girl. I didn't have to recreate the wheel, right? So being a Fly Girl, but also flying to our highest heights always. And then Create is the creator in all of us to create our own destiny and to do whatever we set our minds to, that we're actually able to do that, that there's really nobody holding us back, that you have to be Fly and create it yourself, you know?
Yeah.
Absolutely. And so, it's just been really, really wonderful being able to be an artist and then work behind and work on the other side of the camera and the other side of the business as well. So, you know, I've got a lot to share. So when my actors come to me, or I work with a lot of artists as well. I help them with stage presence and all that other stuff. I work with kids who do public speaking and adults who do public speaking. I do life coaching. I call my coaching the intersection where acting and life coaching meet. Because a lot of the time I'm actually coaching my actors or my artists through some serious life stuff that they have to be able to sort of move and get out of the way so that they're able to shine,
right?
You know, as the artist that they are. And that's something naturally that started happening naturally also in my work, as a coach, you know. And you know, I'm an actress, you know, I'm an actress as well. I'm a dancer, once a dancer, always a dancer. And so I work with dancers and sort of their stage performances as well. You know, I audition as well. Most of the time I swear I'm auditioning so that I can come back and share what I've learned, what I did, what I didn't do, what I need to improve on, with my actors. And it's, you know, what I have shared in the book that I'm doing with them, which is mastering your audition.
Now, did you start way before you came to Chicago, or you started that here?
No, I started that way before I came to Chicago.
Okay.
Yeah, I was, you mean coaching?
Yeah, and the kids and all of that.
Yeah. I started that way. It grew. Oh my goodness, girl, you can't even see me. It grew in Chicago, though.
Okay.
Especially my work with the kids grew more when I got to Chicago. This is funny that I can't find my lighting. I'm going to try moving a little bit. Okay. See, that's already better. There we go. That's it. I think. Okay. When I moved to Chicago, I moved because, God had told me that I was needed here in Chicago. I had never done anything like that before in my life. But I listened and I uprooted my family and we moved to Chicago. And I really thought I was going to work more with adults just because I had really worked more so with adults than children. But I got more, parents who started to come to me and, you know, and ask me to help, you know, coach their children. And so, my work with children has definitely grown more so here in Chicago, which has been incredible. It's been awesome. I love working with children because I'm the biggest kid in the playground, basically. So they love me because I'm just totally a big kid, you know? So, that's it in a nutshell.
So where can people, if you, they want your coaching, they want their kids to be coached, where can they find you?
Yeah, well, I am really, really trying to set myself up as the, you know, premier online coach because there's so many people I could be helping and coaching. And you don't have to be in Chicago or wherever I'm at physically anymore. I mean, corporate America has been doing online meetings for years. I mean, it would be just like you and I are talking.
Right.
It's no different. It's as if you're right in front of me and I'm in front of you. They can reach me via my email. They can, you know, just reach me on my website, which is they can reach me through Kids Way Acting Academy. That's my Kids Way. That's my Kids Acting Academy. Way is spelled W-A-Y, and it stands for who are you? Because my work with kids is really, really giving them that sense of confidence. That's the first thing that we have to really, really work with our kids on is building that sense of self. Because with that sense of self, they can do anything and go anywhere and conquer anything with that. So it's not so much about them being actors, although you know, I get a lot of really great actors and my kids are working. But the heart of my work is to making sure that we're building our kids to be confident so that they can avoid things like being bullied, which is a really, really, really big problem for our kids now. And I'm dealing with that issue myself with my son being bullied in school as we speak, and just making sure that I'm giving him the tools to know how to deal with bullies. So that's a part of my work that I'm really, really specializing and really bringing to the forefront is using acting techniques and the tools to help kids deal with if they're being bullied or to prevent them from being bullied. If, you know, the parents can already tell that their kids lack that sort of confidence, you know, of speaking up. And so that's an area that I'm really, really, really that God is moving me into, because it's a real problem. And we've got to help these kids that are really going through this and falling victims to bullying. I actually made a bullying movie with one of my kids. I encourage all of my kids to write, you know, to create their own destinies by writing their own content. And about 2 years ago now, it seems like just yesterday, but about 2 years ago now, she was 10 at the time, Anna Ambushi, she happened to be bullied because of the color of her skin. She's Kenyan. And she came to me and she was like, you know, Mrs. Josie, I would love for you to, you know, look at my script. I would love for you to produce and direct this, you know, for me. And I was like, no, you're going to direct and produce this. And so that's another part of my work that I do, is like really empowering my kids and teaching them how to go on. And so now she's, I think, 12 and has gone on to win all kind of awards for this movie that I helped to direct. I'm actually the co-director on it with her. And she's gone on to win all kind of awards. But the movie, it's a short film, and it's called Made in His Image. And it's about, you know, the story about this little girl that was bullied. And it's a very, very sweet short story. And she's gone on to be a big advocate and, you know, really helping other kids. It's really, really amazing to see what God has done with her and us, you know, linking up. But yeah, this bullying thing is a real thing. So it's an area that I'm really moving into because there are a lot of really great tools in acting that can really help their kids. I was doing that work sort of subconsciously, because every time I work with my kids, I'm always telling them, like, you know, you've got to learn to be confident, because otherwise the bullies are going to take advantage of you.
Right.
You know, and so it's something I've always spoken into them from day one, because I know that this is a real problem for them. But now I'm doing very more specific work, just, you know, really, really being affected by it firsthand. You know, it's my son started, it had a situation with bullying like maybe a year or two ago. But this time around, it really was on another level, because it had gotten physical, where they were physically, you know, I'm bullying him, which, you know. Mm-hmm. I was about to hurt somebody.
Right.
Seriously. But it was a really good experience to have. And I feel like it helped me to understand how I can better help these kids, like for real, on a real level. So I'm moving into that area now in terms of a more specialized class for kids. So they can contact me through Kids Way Acting Academy. So kidswayactingacademy.com. I also teach adults, and my adult acting class is called Respect for Acting Academy. And you can reach me, you can always reach me through my production company, which is beflycreate.com. It'll lead you to, you know,
everything,
exactly.
Okay.
It's the hub. And BeFly Create, it's spelled B as in boy, E, and then fly, F-L-Y, and create. So beflycreate.com. So, and in terms of where they can find me in Chicago, I teach a Saturday kids and adult class at Connect Gallery. Do you know where that's at?
No.
Nope. Connect Gallery is in Hyde Park, which is
one of those buildings in there where the job.
It's an actual gallery, black owned, and it's a beautiful space, and it's in Harper Court, which is that little block right behind. So I'm there every Saturday. That's at Connect Gallery. And then on Thursday, I teach out in the South Suburbs because I have to come out and be here for my suburban peoples. And so I'm in the suburbs on Thursday evenings at Flossmoor Community House.
Okay.
So yeah. Yeah, I think I've shared it all. Have I forgotten anything?
Because I think you got it all. I think you got it all.
Yeah.
I know you did a special for Black Friday. Did you have something going out?
Yes, I do. Actually, good. Good for you. Good looking out, Mama, because this is a great time to jump on. I love giving, and I love that, you know, during the holidays, everybody, you know, gives their holiday discounts and stuff. And I'm like, why not? Mm-hmm. And so I participate every holiday. And so right now I am offering a 30% off of all classes. And you can take advantage of some private lessons too, some discounts on private lessons. You'll have to say that you'll have to use the Dr. Renee Matthews code. How about that? You got to say you heard it and you watched Dr. Renee Matthews in order to get the code. How about that?
Awesome. Well, thank you so much. This has been wonderful. And I know that you gave some great nuggets. What's one last piece of advice you would give to that aspiring actor or dancer?
To not wait on anybody. Don't wait on anybody. You've got to be single-mindedness of focus. You've got to be doing the work. You know, God isn't he's not up there, you know, pulling strings. You know, he says, study to show thyself approved. So you got to be doing the homework. Nowadays, there's so many ways, you know, you could be shooting your own project and uploading it, and getting with other friends and getting yourself a team. If you're not a good writer, hook up with somebody that is a writer and shoot. I mean, you can shoot a short film on your iPhone nowadays. Stay busy, stay creative. That's what we are. We're artists. So stay creative and, you know, post stuff on Facebook and post stuff on Instagram and on social media. And then, you know, if you want to get an agent, you know, find out who the agents are and, you know, get some headshots done and send out a letter and just be proactive. You can't just be sitting around and thinking that somebody is going to, you know, do it for you or it's just magically going to happen. You got to put some energy and some action. You know, I'm always sort of blogging. And one of the things I'm always talking about is thoughts and actions. Right. And I'm showing you with my life that I have a thought and I put it to action. That's what I do. And that's what I'm doing when I'm sharing. Even the thought that I'm sharing is an action. Then I'm putting energy toward it. The energy is that I'm hoping that you're going to read it because you're going to see it and you're going to learn that much more about me. And you're going to, and you're going to see that I'm not just talking the talk. I'm actually walking the walk too. You know, all of my thoughts and actions will all sort of make sense one day as I continue to just do them and live my life. So I'm, you know, trying to help somebody. I'm always trying to help somebody.
Exactly.
Right?
That's me too. That's, like I said, the show is here to motivate and inspire people to live the life they deserve. I want everyone to live their best, most abundant life.
Absolutely. And it not be like a cool sort of catchphrase. Right.
No, it's something you can, it's tangible.
You really can actually live your best life.
You really can.
Yeah, you really can. And we're a testimony of that right now.
Exactly.
The fact that you and I connected, that you had a thought, and you followed through with the action of getting in touch with me. We're here now because of you.
Yes.
You know, and that's another thing I'm always telling my actors and everybody that I'm blessed to be able to coach through, you know, that, you know, you're really writing your own story. You're writing it every day. Yep. You're writing every choice that you make. You're essentially writing your own story. So write good things, you know, like write, if you don't like a person, write them out your life. You can do that. Yep. You have control of that.
And every day we get another chance to start all over.
Absolutely. And so if you mess up or if you got with the wrong people, it's okay. You can start over the next day. You can go another direction. You know, I always just want the best for everyone because we really are better together. You know, it doesn't make sense for us to be, you know, we don't all have to like each other and we don't all have to be friends. That I learned the hard way. But we can get along and be respectful, you know, and respect what each other is doing and respect, you know, each other's lanes and that kind of stuff, you know? And I think that we need to be doing more of that, you know? So,
definitely.
Yeah, I got a lot to say to them.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much. This was fabulous. And I know that it's going to bless many people.
Oh,
and,
I hope so.
Definitely. Sina. I will include the link to your websites so that everyone can get in touch with you, because I know you're going to have a lot of folks that are like, wait a minute.
Oh, I hope so.
Because I'm telling you, her people are working. Her people are all across, you know, on TV, they're in movies, they're everywhere. They are working.
They
so
really
clearly
are.
Whatever she's saying is working, you know, from the children to the adults, they're busy. So that's a great thing. And of course, we're going to look out for all the projects you have coming. Definitely, we want to hear all more about your book when it comes out. So we'll be on the lookout for that.
Awesome.
And I know that you're a New Year baby.
How do you know? You've been doing your work, haven't you, girl?
Yes. And I know you're having a big birthday. So I'm very excited for you because that's only a few weeks away.
That's only a few weeks away. And you'll be there. How about that?
Okay.
That's a personal invation.
Thank you. But I saw that. I was like, wow, to be born on January 1.
Yes.
What a way to start the new year.
I'm special.
Yes, very, very special.
My sister's born December 25th. My sister's a Christmas baby.
Oh, my God. That's crazy.
My mother had a thing around the holidays. I don't know.
No, but you know, they said Valentine babies are the ones born around this time.
Right. Valentine's baby. That's right. There you go. There it is.
Said, so Valentine's Day, like that whole week.
Have to do. We can do the math. We can do the math. Absolutely. But thank you, sweetheart. Thank you so much for, you know, having me on your show. God bless it. I really wish and pray that God would continue to, you know, just bless it and that it be everything that you want it to be, that you desire it to be. Because you're doing everything, you know, to make it happen, to make it that.
Yeah,
so it's my pleasure and God bless you with all you that you're too. Doing. All right. Let's talk soon.
Okay.
All right. Bye, sweetheart.
Bye. Time to try Thinx. Thinx can't make that family time any easier, but they can make travel a lot easier. They make amazing presents, and the final sale of the year is 20% off of everything, December 26th to December 31st. So that's today to New Year's Eve. You get an extra $10 off with my link, shethinks.com/Renee.